Hello guys, welcome back to Chris Poly Channel. This video I want to share about Blackstar Awakening Weapon questline and my rage enhancing this thing. Okay, before I share about this questline, by the way, now Chris Poly Channel have membership option. If you want to support me directly, I will very grateful, and as special thanks, I will put your name on my video depend on your support level. And be notice for some level there are have some limit, so make sure you didn't get run out for this limited space. And I will put your name on every subsequent video that I release for the duration of your support. And if you want to join my membership to support me directly, you can go to any platform for Patreon, Karya Karsa, and YouTube membership. I already put link for this membership on this video description, or you can check on top right of this video. I already put card for Patreon link. Special thanks to all my membership for direct support via Patreon, Karya Karsa, or YouTube membership. And also my current member, Lots, Zekru, Dubia Dude, Lee Cham, Spartan Guild from NA Server, Jimmy Snake, Doki, Transcester, Aghanim Scepter, Lazy Leader, Umaru, Estimer, Renegades X, S Gold member, and also all my Silver and Bronze member. Thank you so much for all your direct support. This will make Chris Poly Channel running and growing more faster. Okay, since 20 January 2021 update, we just got major update Blackstar Awakening Weapon, and also major update to get Blackstar Glove. But in this video, I will focus about Blackstar Awakening Weapon. Okay, first thing you need to do is prepare your Remnant of Reef that you can get by killing Dark Reef Boss with low chance. Or you can buy this Remnant of Reef from Central Market if have stock. But as you see, because this update just come, this Remnant of Reef stock already depleted and so many people order it. But don't worry, if you play seasonal character, you will got this Season Morning Frost Flower. As you see, this item, Season Morning Frost Flower, you can exchange it 25 pieces to become Remnant of Reef. But be notice, this exchange quest, you only can do it one time per family. You just need to bring the Season Morning Frost Flower 25 pieces to Patrigio NPC at Velia around this area and just talk and click quest and just scroll down, and as you see at the end of this list he will offer Season Quest Remnant of Reef. And after you finish this quest and exchange your Season Morning Frost Flower, you will got this Remnant of Reef one piece that you can use for any character in your family. And also you need to prepare this Spectre Energy that you can get by grinding at certain area. And if you want to get this Spectre Energy more often, you can grinding at Thronewood Forest at Odelita region. And the last item that you need to prepare is any kind of boss gear with base level, I mean zero enchantment. You can use any kind of boss gear weapon or any kind of boss gear armor with base enchantment level. But be notice, any kind of boss gear that have enchantment level either plus 1, you cannot use it as material to craft this Blackstar process. Okay, to start this quest, you just need to right-click this Remnant of Reef and click NPC location. And if you open your map, you will point it to Martakien at Northernwood Plantation. Okay, just go to this location. Okay, arrive at target location, you just need to talk with Martakien and click quest. You need to choose Blackstar gear questline that you want to craft. Okay, in this case, I will choose this Blackstar Awakening weapon. But be notice, if your character haven't do main quest, as you see, my guardian actually didn't do any main quest, you still can take this Blackstar questline. Okay, let's start this Awakening Blackstar weapon. Okay, just talk with Martakien again. And then just talk with another NPC beside her. And hand over this Remnant of Reef. And you will finish this quest. And take another quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, Tense Archaeologist. Okay, after that you need to talk with Bram at this area inside Calpion City. Okay, just go. Okay, arrive at this area, just go to NPC location. And just talk, and just click chat, and choose interaction, send Oliver regards. And you will finish this quest. And take another quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, Secretive House. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to show Remnant of Reef Shard to Giovan Grolin at his residence at Kaya Vier. Actually, Remnant of Reef Shard is this new item. And be notice, don't throw this item, because you will need it in this quest line. Okay, just go to target NPC location at Kaya Pier around this area. Okay, arrive at this area, just go to second floor and go inside and just talk with this NPC and click chat and choose this interaction and you will finish this quest. And then take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, King's Record. Okay, after that you need to examine Guy Sayric's memories. Actually, you just need to interact with this bookshelf and click chat, and you will finish this quest. And after that, just report to this NPC to finish this quest, and then take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Penitent High Priest. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to meet Baco Ladericio at Abaddon Monastery around this area on map. Okay, just go to NPC location. Okay, arrive at this area, just talk with target NPC, and you will finish this quest and take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Secret Order Confirm. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to examine Secret Order given by Shadow Knight. Actually, you just need to go inside well around this cave and talk with some item. Okay, I will show you where its location. I will fast forward this video. Okay, arrive at this area, just interact with this Wirken Order, and you will finish this quest. And then to report this quest, you need to go back to Baco Ladericio again, at outside of this cave. Okay, just go back to this NPC location. Okay, just report this quest. And take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Painful Day of Descent. Okay, to finish this quest, you just need to go to target location at Calpheon's Rind, around this area on map. Okay, just go to target location. Okay, inside this area, just stop with target location. And talk again. And you will finish this quest. And then just autopet to target location to report this quest around this area on map. Okay, just go. Okay, arrive at target location, just talk with her, and you will finish this quest and take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Historic Heal. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to show Remnant of Riftshard to Lucie Le Monet around this area at Archer Guard Post. Okay, just go to target location. Okay, arrive at Archer Guard Post, just go to target NPC, and just talk, and click chat, and you will finish this quest. And after that, just take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Bearing Hope. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to hand over Old Spectre Cloth to Tulit, and hand over Remnant of Riftshard to Tulit. You can find Tulit NPC around this area, near Lopi Tree Forest, inside his hidden cave. Okay, just go to target location. Okay, arrive at this area. Just stop around this area, and just climb into inside this hidden cave. And there are the NPC Tulit. You just need to talk and click chat. Just hand over this old Spectre Cloth, and also hand over this Remnant of Riftshard to Tulit, and you will finish this quest. And take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Consume to the Soul. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to kill some monster that appear around this area. As you see, this is Trace of Corruption. You just need to kill it. Actually, this monster is not too hard. After you kill it, you will finish this quest. And then you just need to interact with this Chapras record near this Tulit NPC. And choose this chat and interact. And then click chat again to finish this quest. After that, just report back again to Tulit NPC. And after that, you will automatically talk with Black Spirit and get the next quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, Somewhat Pitiful. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to hand over Sharp Blood Fragment to Laura at S Forest. Okay, just go to target NPC. Okay, arrive at target NPC, just talk with her and click chat and hand over this item, and you will finish this quest. And then you will got some crossroad. If you choose the left side to the Altar of the Fallen God, you will encounter boss with high AP, 260 AP recommended. But actually, this hard boss monster is the fastest route than another side on the right into the Lopi Tree Forest, you still will encounter this boss, but this boss have lower AP, just 150 AP recommended. And if you take the longest path at the right side into the Lopi Tree Forest, you will need to kill some Fadus monster before can encounter this boss. But we notice any path you choose, you still can finish it in party or platoon, so you can seek help with another player to finish this quest. Okay, I will choose the fastest route on the left side to kill this 200 AP boss and just select the quest, and you will automatically get the next quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, to the Altar of the Fallen God. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to defeat Incarnation of Corruption and sacrifice A of Desolation at the Brazier. Actually, you need to process this A of Anguish with 3 pieces concentrate boss aura that you can get it by hitting any kind of boss gear, either armor or weapon with base enchantment level. Okay, I will take some boss gear with base enchantment level. Actually, you can use any kind of boss gear weapon or any kind of boss gear armor that have base enchantment level. Okay, in this case, I will use any kind of weapon. And then open your processing window and go to hitting menu and choose any kind of boss gear and start processing. After quite a while, you will got this concentrate boss aura and do the same thing until you got 3 pieces concentrate boss aura. And after you got all ingredient, you just need to go to manufacture and choose this A of Anguish and this 3 pieces concentrate boss aura and start processing. After quite a while, you will got this A of Desolation. Okay, after that, just right click and go to NPC location, and you will be pointed to this brazier at this star end area. Okay, just go to target location. Okay, arrive at target location, just interact with this brazier and click chat and choose this test of star end. And you will got this new quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon Combat, Incarnation of Corruption. And just prepare to encounter this boss. You can kill this boss in party or platoon if you didn't strong enough to kill it. And after you finish to kill it, you will finish this quest. And just call Black Spirit to report this part of this quest. And then just talk with this brazier and click chat. And offer this A of Desolation to this brazier. And you will finish this quest. And after that, just talk again with this brazier and take next quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, Tragic Fate. Okay, to finish this quest, you just need to talk again to this brazier and interact and listen to the flame. And you will finish this quest. And after that, you will got this Flame of Amelia Ornette knowledge. As you see, this is the new knowledge, the Fall of Amelia Ornette. And then you will automatically talk to Black Spirit to take next quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, back to Kaya Pierre. Okay, to finish this quest, you just need to go back to North Kaya Pierre to talk with this NPC. Okay, just go to target location. Okay, arrive at this house, just go to the second floor and just talk to target NPC and click chat and choose this interaction, show Black Star Cloud. And you will finish this quest and take another quest, Black Star Awakening Weapon, the greatest blacksmith of the continent. Okay, to finish this quest, you need to go to Dorin Mogrim NPC inside Helm Cave at Media Region. Okay, just go to target NPC. Okay, arrive at this location, just go inside this Helm Cave and meet this blacksmith, Dorin Mogrim, and just talk with him. And you will finish this quest and take another quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, Power of Ancient Ator. Okay, to finish this quest, you just need to interact and hand over this Blackstar Cloud. And then click chat again to activate this ancient power. And you will finish this quest. And then to report this quest, you just need to interact with this crystal ball in the middle of this room. And you will finish this quest and take another quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, Blackstar Awakening Weapon Fragment. Okay, to finish this quest, you just need to talk with Dorin Mogrim again to finish this quest and take another quest, Blackstar Awakening Weapon, Spectre Energy. At this point, you need to hand over Spectre Energy that you already prepared before to Doreen Mulgrim. And if you already have Spectre Energy in your character inventory, you just need to click chat and hand over this item. And you will finish this quest and take another quest, crafting Black Star Awakening Weapon that's suitable with your class. In my case, because I do this Black Star Awakening Weapon questline using Guardian, I will get this crafting Black Star Jordan quest. And after that, just click chat to hand over this Black Star Awakening Weapon piece. And after that, just interact with this crystal ball. And click chat and choose this interaction, craft a Black Star Jordan, and you will finish this quest, and Doreen Mulgrim NPC will start to craft this Black Star Awakening Weapon. And after that, just talk with Doreen Mulgrim again to take this Black Star Awakening Weapon. And after that, you already done to doing this Black Star Awakening Weapon questline. And as you see, this is how it's look for Black Star Awakening Weapon for Guardian, Black Star Jordan. Okay, let's enhance this weapon. Okay, to enhance this Black Star Awakening Weapon from plus 1 until plus 15, same as another Black Star gear, you will need this Concentrate Magical Blackstone Weapon. And from plus 1 until plus 7, you will have Guarantee Enchantment. And to go to plus 8, using 0 file stack, you will got around 70% chance. Okay, just enhance it to plus 8. And as you see, to go to plus 9, using 0 file stack, this success chance already reduced slightly to become 26% chance. Okay, I will use 10 file stack to enhance it. And as you see, using 13 file stack, we will get 46.94% chance to success. Okay, just enhance it and keep trying. I think I just didn't get this RNG for this enchantment level. Okay, just keep trying. And to go to plus 10, I think I will use this Advice of Oak plus 13. Okay, just confirm it. And as you see, for 33 file stack, we will got 61% chance to success. Okay, just enhance it. Okay, next, to go to plus 11, I will use this 40 file stack. As you see, for 43 file stack, we will got 53% chance to go to plus 11. Okay, just enhance it. And keep trying. And then to go to plus 12, I will use this Advice of Oak plus 50. And as you see, 53 file stack, I just got 42% chance to success to go to plus 12. Okay, let's enhance it. And I think I will use this 51 file stack from my another band. And as you see, to go to plus 13, using 51 file stack, we will got 24.4% chance to success. Okay, I think I will try my luck. And as you see, I just got this RNG. And to go to plus 14, if I use 88 file stack from my nether band, I just got 24.5% chance to success. I think I will use this force enhanced feature that will consume 29 concentrate magical blackstone weapon and reduce its maximum durability 80 point. I think this is will save my file stack for another enchantment. Okay, before that, I will restore this maximum durability one by one and hope get some bonus maximum durability using this method, but I think I didn't lucky enough to get this maximum durability bonus. Okay, let's continue to enhance this weapon using force enhance feature and just enhance it, and then just repair again its maximum durability using this method and hope got maximum durability bonus again. But I think in this time I still didn't lucky enough to get this maximum durability bonus. Okay, just continue to enhance this weapon. And to go to plus 15, if I use 88 file stack, I just got 19.6% chance to success. And if I use 137 file stack, I just got 29.4% chance to success. And I think I will use this force enhanced feature again that will consume 36 concentrate magical blackstone weapon and 100 maximum durability. Okay, just force enhance this weapon, and I just got plus 15 for this weapon. And let's repair this maximum durability weapon using same method and hope got this maximum durability bonus again. And as you see, I just got this maximum durability bonus using this method. And as you see, I just got another one maximum durability bonus. Okay, let's continue to enhance this weapon. From plus 15 to pre, you will start to use Flavor's Magical Blackstone. That you can get this Flavor's Magical Blackstone by hitting Mass Pure Magic 1 piece with 1 piece Sharp Black Crystal Shard and 1 piece Hard Black Crystal Shard. And to go to pre-enchantment level, I will try to use this Advice of Oak plus 25. And as you see, for 28 file stack, we will got 49.69% chance to success. Okay, just enhance it. And if you still fail, just keep trying. And as you see, I just got this pre-enchantment level. And next, I will use this 40 file stack. Okay, just confirm it. And as you see, for 43 file stack, we will got 56.31% chance to success. Okay, just enhance it. And to go to 3, when I record this video, we can use 100 crown stone to save this enchantment from dropping when fail. Okay, let's take this amazing item and continue enhancing. And don't forget to check this use crown stone menu. And to go to 3, I will use this 60 file stack. As you see, 63 file stack, we will got 24.82% chance to success. And using 88 file stack, we will got 33.32% chance to success. Okay, I think I will use this file stack and start enhancing. And as you see, I just got 3 enchantment level. And to go to tap, using Crownstone, when I record this video, it will consume 591 Crownstone. Okay, I will use 137 file stack. And as you see, for 137 file stack, we will got 7.5% chance to success. Okay, let's enhance it without skip animation. And as you see, I just failed for the first time. Okay, let's try again for the second time. And this is still fail. Okay, for the third time. And still fail. And my durability just depleted. Okay, let's repair this maximum durability. But I think in this time, I will use Artisan Memory to faster this recording. Okay, let's continue to enhance this weapon. And as you see, I still fail to enhance this Black Star Awakening weapon to tap. And my Crown Stone already depleted. Okay, I will take Crown Stone from Challenge Reward and also from Black Spirit Save. And some Crown Stone from previous Black Spirit Adventure. I think this is enough for another attempt. Okay, let's continue to enhance this weapon using Crown Stone. And as you see, I still fail to enhance this Black Star Awakening weapon to tap. I think I will try to use this ultimate tools, J-Hammer of Loyalty. Okay, let's take this item and choose this J-Hammer of Loyalty and start enhancing. As you see, I still fail to enhance this weapon to tap. I think I still have some J-Hammer of Loyalty with my ranger. Okay, I will take this J-Hammer of Loyalty from my ranger and start continue to enhance it to tap. And just confirm it. Okay, I still fail for this last attempt. Okay, I think I will continue this enchantment to go to Tet in another time. Actually, this 3 Awakening weapon nearly same with Tet Dandelion weapon without Chapras level, but have one more AP. And as you see for this item effect, this 3 Black Star weapon has additional 7 damage to all species than this Tet Dandelion weapon. Okay, let's try this 3 Black Star Awakening weapon to this Dark Reef boss Event Cactum Rider. But before that, I will take some event quest from this NPC. And just go to this Cactum Rider location to encounter this boss. Actually, I didn't find any significant difference from using this 3 Awakening Black Star weapon than Tet Dandelion Awakening weapon. But I'm sure for Tet Black Star Awakening weapon will be more significant different than Vanilla Pen Dandelion weapon, because this item effect will boost significantly from 3 to 10 enchantment level for this Black Star Awakening weapon. Okay guys, that's all about Black Star Awakening weapon questline and my experience enhancing this weapon. Hope you also can get this Black Star Awakening weapon and success to enhance it. If you like this video, you can like and subscribe to my channel for another guide and update. Thank you for watching. See you next time.